Hi guys, welcome back to the next episode of our Battle Royale tutorial series. Today we are going to be working on our options video menu. As you can see, I have it set up here. So we can change our display mode, we can change our screen resolution, we can change anti-aliasing, our render distance will be a slider. Ambient occlusion checkbox, and you can change all of these different settings. So we'll go about setting this up inside our widget. So I'll just close this down and open up my editor. So the first thing we're going to do is open up the video menu. Okay. And inside here, what we want to do is if we grab this text and we'll just delete the settings part of it and make caps lock video. Okay, just drag that in, compile and save. Now, the image, let's rename this to background or BG for short. And in our canvas panel, we need a horizontal box. So our horizontal box into our canvas panel, and we will anchor this sorry, we will anchor this across the page like so, and we'll set our offset bottom to 570 and our offset right to 0. And this will be our title menu. Okay, let's just check this first, just to see. Yeah, we'll keep it there. Okay, so now we grab in our text for our title. We'll drag it into the title box. We'll just rename this title box. Okay, and now the text, we will give a padding of 50 from the left and 30 from the top. Okay, if we get rid of our title box now, just minimize that. We're gonna need another horizontal box. We'll drag it into the canvas panel again, and this will be our basic menu box. So our basic menu box. Okay. Now our basic menu box again will be anchored across the full screen, and we will have a top offset of 80 because this here is 80. We'll have a right offset of 0 and a bottom offset of 285. Now, where I get the 285 from is the 80, the 650 for the height resolution, minus the 80, and then half it gives us a 285. Okay, so now the next thing we need is another horizontal box. Okay. And the horizontal box will be dropped inside our basic menu box. And this will be our video menu left. So video menu left. And the video menu left will have a right padding of 550. Okay, and also set this to fill. So what that does is the horizontal box will fill up the other horizontal box, and because we give it a padding of 550, it halves the horizontal box. That way we can place things inside this half. So inside this half, we now want two vertical boxes, one for the classes and one for the buttons. So inside here, we will say vertical box. Okay. And this vertical box we will just call menu class box. Okay. And inside here, our menu class box again will be set to fill. Okay, so right now it fills the entire box. We only want it to fill halfway. So the other vertical box will do that for us. So if we drag in another vertical box, this will be our button box. We set it to fill and just rename it button box. Okay. So now that we have that set up, if we grab our basic menu box and copy it and paste it into our canvas panel, so we have another horizontal box, and we just position this from the bottom, 0. Okay, and let me just check from the top will be 365, and that aligns it alongside this one. Okay, now the difference with this horizontal box is we're going to have two of these secondary horizontal boxes inside, so we have classes here, buttons here, classes here, buttons here, classes here, buttons here, and this bit here will be left empty. You can put other things in here if you like. I'm just going to leave it empty. So to do this, let's grab this button box first of all, and we'll rename this advanced menu box, and this one here. Just check and see what I named it. I named it video menu advanced left. I'll just put box at the end of it. Quite a big name. Yeah, and in here it's just similar to the other one. So this one will be our advanced menu left class. So this will be our classes that's in here. And here it will be advanced menu left buttons. Okay. So now we want another one of these to be here. So we'll just copy this and paste it there. Okay, so we now have another one. And yeah, so this one here, because there's going to be two of these horizontal boxes inside this horizontal box, we don't need the padding. So if we set this to 0 and set the second one, sorry, not this. This will be our, yeah, that's right. Sorry. So set this to 0. We don't need it. And the second one, make sure it's full, set it to 0. And now we have our boxes lined up. Okay, so we can just rename this one video menu advanced right box. Okay, and rename this one. What did I name it here? So advanced menu right class and advanced menu right buttons. Okay, so now that we've got that set up, it's time to start adding in content. So inside our menu class box, we're going to want a text. So we'll just grab this one here and copy it and grab this box and paste that in. Okay, now this text is going to be 20 for a size for the font, and the padding, we can get rid of the padding top so that it just gets placed underneath, And we'll call this basic. And this will be your basic sentence. Okay? So, we can minimize that. And we're now going to need some more text. So, if we just grab this one here, we'll copy it and paste it in here again. And with this one here, we are going to want to say the size to 18. We don't want it to be bold, we want it to be regular. Okay. And the text, this will be display mode. Better put a space there. And yeah, the colour. If we just grab our dropper, and I'm just going to put it over here so we get a different colour. This is entirely customizable. And finally, we want a bit of padding between the display mode and the subtitle here. So if we go to padding and top, we'll set that to 10. So just a small bit of padding. Now with this, we can copy it and paste it two more times. And we will just say display mode will be screen resolution this time. Resolution. Okay. And the next one will be our anti-aliasing. Aliasing. Okay. Now that we've got them in, we can grab the basic again, copy it, and we want to put it into this box here. So in this box we can paste it and change, where are we? Let's click it, change the basic to advanced. Advanced. Okay, this will be our advanced menu. And if we grab the display mode text at the top, copy it, and we'll start pasting it in here. So there's the first one, and we will call this render distance. Okay, and we need another 1, 2, 3, 4. So, okay, this display mode will be ambient occlusion. And this one will be texture quality. My spelling's atrocious today. Quality. And dynamic shadows. And finally in this menu, effects. Okay. Now we want some over here as well. So what to do is we grab the right class menu and just paste another text in. And for this text, the padding will be a little different because we are having to offset below. So for the padding top, let's set that to 40. And padding left, let's set that to 20. And this steers it over a bit towards the center point. So that is everything for there. We just need to set display mode to foliage this thing. And let's then copy this button because it has the same padding and paste it in here two more times. And you can add more if you like. Yeah. You can add more if you like, but I'm just going to use these ones just now. So this will be a padding of 10. And we'll call it motion blur. And this this one again, padding of 10, and this one will be our bloom. Okay, so now we can start adding in our buttons to start populating a menu. So under our button box, this one here, sorry, we want to click input and you can see the combo box. So if we drag a combo box into here, you can see it appears up here. Okay. Now the padding left we'll set to 50, padding top 40, and padding right 50. Okay. Now if we scroll down, the array elements are everything that's going to be inside the pop-up menu. So if we drop down 3, and the first one will be full screen, the second one will be windowed, and the third one borderless. Okay, and then the selected option, okay, we'll just set to full screen, and this is just the default option. So if we compile and press play, you can see the default is there, and we have the drop down menu, and we can select others. Okay, so now we want to customize this button. So if we scroll down, we can see style and combo button style. So let's check out the button style itself. Okay, I'll just open up mines from the other menu just so I can get some reference from the other editor, sorry. So yeah, so the button style, I don't want anything to be on the background. So if we just go to button style normal, and for this I want to set the alpha to 0, and that gets rid of the background. Okay, so minimize normal, go to hovered state, do the same, 0, okay, and the press state the same, so 0, okay. Now the down arrow, I also don't want this to appear. You may like it, I don't, so go to tint again and go to the alpha and press 0. You can change the down arrow by putting in your own image, but for this I won't be doing that. The menu border, again, this is going to be a little different, because, let me see, the menu border itself, let me just show you. So I'll copy this first of all. If we compile and save and press play, go into options, the menu border is the colour in the background here. Now if we set this to, if we set our alpha to 0, it means this will be see-through and it will start clashing with whatever's underneath, and this can be a problem later on down the line when we have other things down here. So for this I'm just going to set the tint for the menu border, and I'm going to give it a kind of a blue-ish colour, the same as what I have in my background here, and set the alpha to 0.7. Okay, now when we compile and save and press play, bring up our options, you see it's just a little bit grey. Okay, so we can minimise this one and the item style. So I'll just drag this out a little bit so you can see it. So select a focused brush. I have it set to, yeah, just left it black. The active hovered, that's this one here. And what I did for that was I clicked here, got my dropper, and just placed it there. And what this does is, if we press play, bring up our options, the hovered is that color. So we also want the selected to be that color. So if I quit and click on the button again and scroll down to the active hover brush, if I click the tint and copy the hex code RGB and press OK, and then say the active brush to the same. Okay, and now that sets up the selected. Now we can see there's a bit of padding to the left here, and that can be a little bit off-putting, so I'm going to bring these the text here over so it's in line with this text. Okay, so let's scroll down to our text color, and the text color we want to be white, and selected text again white, and the foreground background let's go white. Okay, and scroll down a little bit more, scroll up, and you see we have our padding, our content padding. So we click our content padding, and padding from the left set to 0, and when we compile and save, options, and we go full screen, you can now see that we have it in line. Okay, now this is a little too bright, so I'm going to take the colour of the active and the selected and just drag the brightness down a little. So again, if I scroll down and I go to the active hover brush and the active brush, click the tint, and I'll just drag this down and then copy and paste the hex code into active brush. Okay, and compile and save. Now when we bring up the button, it looks nice. Okay. Now if you don't like the extra space here, what you can do for that is you can play around with the padding at the top. So if we scroll up, go padding right, we can set this to 80. Or 100, or 110, oh, I think 100 is fine. So we can compile and save and try this. So now it's a little bit better. Okay, so let's save that. Now our screen resolution is going to be similar. So it's going to be the same button. The only difference being is the content inside will be different. So you can put in any resolution you like. I'm going to grab this combo box, I'll rename it, and we'll say display mode drop for display mode dropdown. We will copy this and paste it into the button box that appears down here. Now we want to change our padding top to 10, and just see if that lines up. I think I'm gonna want it to be 9. And we can see the padding at the side here is a little bit too much, so we'll change this to 90, just so it doesn't cut off the text. Okay, compile, save, play. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, I think that's fine. There's sometimes a pixel or two of a difference when you're doing your padding. It's sometimes not as accurate as possible. So for the second button here for screen resolution, under the array elements, our full screen, I'll set this to 1920 by 1080. For our number one, we'll say 1440 by 900, and our borderless, we'll set this to 1366 by 768, and we can add one more in. Let's say 1280 by 768. Now, these can be anything you want. You can add in more if you like. It's entirely up to yourself. I'm just using these as they're kind of the most common. And obviously the selected option is now, is no longer full screen, so I'm just going to set this to 1920 by 1080 as a default. Compile and save. And when we press play, we have it now here. Okay, so let's quit that. And the anti-aliasing we're going to do now. So let's rename this to S res drop. Okay, screen resolution drop. And copy it, paste that again, so we have it here. And then change these to low, medium, high, and epic. Okay, and the selected option will just set it to high. Compile the save, and you see the changes. And play it and make sure it's lined up okay. Yeah, that seems okay. You can play around with the padding if it doesn't line up properly. Okay. So, the next thing we need our render distance, and I'm going to choose a slider for this. So if I type in slider, and we just drag that into our advanced menu left buttons. Okay, we now have it here. And for this, the padding will be similar to the buttons at the top, so let's click here. Padding left will be 60, padding top will be 50, and the padding right will be 60. Okay, and if you scroll down, you can customize this. So the slider bar color, I'm going to set again to this color here. Okay. Click on my slider bar again and just make sure this is perfect white. Okay, the step size, I think I'm going to set it to 0.1, and the value for default I'll set it to 1, so the render distance is as high as it possibly can be. And you can play around with the style as well if you like, so the normal bar image. This is currently set to white, so let's just see. Yeah, we have it okay. We don't need to deal with any of these, and the bar thickness I think I'll put to 2.5 pixels. Okay, just so it's a little bit thicker. And that's everything for that just now. So then we want our ambient occlusion. And this is going to be a checkbox. So checkbox. And drag this down here. Now, a checkbox always appears very, very small. And it's really annoying to work with. So if you just follow along. First of all, I'm going to change this slider. And just change the name of it to R distance slider. Okay, and this checkbox will be our AO checkbox. Okay, now for the checkbox, the padding will be 120 by 20. 120 by 20 by 130. Okay, that kind of a centers it out. If I scroll down, you have all these different, we can have toggle buttons and things like so, and all these different colors and images we can check. Now, the first thing we need to deal with is you can see the checkbox is absolutely tiny. So if we just grab the unchecked, the hovered, and depressed, okay, and the sizes I used before were 25 by 25. So 25 by 25, and scroll down, 25 by 25, and 25 by 25. Now the checked image, we're going to have to do them as well. Okay, so checked image 25 by 25, the hovered 25 by 25, and the pressed 25 by 25. Okay, now we want our checked image tint. So again, I'm going to use this color. You can use any color you like. And what this does is, if we click on our checked image now and we set the check state to checked, you can see it gives it a nice tint. Now we need to do the same for the hovered states and pressed states. So if I just highlight this and copy the hex code, scroll down to the hovered image for the checked, and set the hex code to the same as the one before. So there we go. And the pressed image the same. Okay. Compile and save. Press play. Bring up our options. You can now see the check boxes here. And if you uncheck it, it goes to kind of a whitey grey colour, and check it goes back to our tint. Okay. So next, we want our texture quality, dynamic shadows, and effects. Okay, so this again is going to be similar to this one here. So if we copy this, click on our box again, and paste it in. Okay, so as you can see, it's a little off center. Is it content padding maybe? Let's set that to 0. And up here, set this to centered for the horizontal alignment. Okay. So let's grab this one, center it, and set the padding right to 0. Okay. Now if we compile and save, let's have a look at that. Okay. This still seems a little off. Okay, so the problem is the horizontal alignment for the full screen. Set this to centered, and then set the padding right to 50. It was 90, but we set it to 50. Then click this one and do the same. So horizontal alignment, set the padding right to 50, and this one 50, and that now centers it down the horizontal box. And we can then reset this back to I think it was 60. Yeah, and 50. Just double check that. 1660, sorry. So 60, 50, 60. Yeah, let's keep that there like that. And then if we grab this again, we want to set the horizontal alignment again and set this to 120, 20, 130, and this one to 50 with horizontal alignment. So let's compile, save and play, and that lines up much better. I think this could maybe be pushed over to the left a little. Yeah. So if we grab this slider bar and just set the right to 70. And the left to 50. Let's check that. Yeah, that seems well. Quit. Grab this. Copy it. Well, right now we don't have it named, so let's just rename it to texture. Quality. Hang on. This is the button, so T. Let's say texture. Texture drop. Okay. Copy it. Paste it in here twice. This one here, our dynamic shadows button. So D. We'll just call it shadows drop. And this one here will be our effects, so effects drop. Okay, compile, save, play. Let's have a look. Yep, they seem okay. Maybe bring this one up a little, and also this one too. So let's quit that. Let's click on this. We'll set the padding top to 8. Grab the other one. Set the padding top to 8. So now we want the foliage to have the same, so let's grab one of the buttons, copy it, and paste it into this box here. Okay, so now we'll rename this foliage drop. Okay, now this padding here is 40 at the top, so we want to grab this and say 40. Okay. Compile and save. Now the motion blur and the bloom will be a simple checkbox. So let's copy that. And click on this button box again. And paste twice. Now this obviously has a padding of 20. We want that to be 10. And this one to be 10. Okay, that's a padding top. So compile, save, play. Now we have everything set up, so we have our full screen working, we have our menu popping up, and we also have our low, medium, high settings set up. We have a slider, and we have our checkboxes. Okay, so that comes to the end of this video. In the next video, we'll see about adding some functionality to the buttons.